Well, number one, you got to be a good manager of it. You just can't go out there and expect it to work without gradually growing into it. The first year we did cover crops, we only had 20 acres of annual ryegrass. From there, you know, the next year went to 200. You just don't want to put your whole farm out there in a cover crop without seeing how it works initially. So with that alone, that's the biggest change. You got to be on top of things and be a good manager. And it's exciting because you have to realize you got to have to change. You know, you're not going to just be stuck in your old ways of the old school of thinking. So you have to be open-minded. What's really helped us is that we learned from our peers, the people that used cover crops or used been no-tilling for many years. So we attend conferences that other people attend that we can share information with. So that's very important for education alone right there. Soil health to me means a living soil. I actually didn't know that until I got involved with no-till and going to no-till conference. I heard a presentation by someone at the National No-Till Conference in Cincinnati that just opened up my eyes that that soil is actually living. There's a lot of microbes out there. So that's what soil health means to me. And we got to protect it and keep feeding that living soil. So that's the reason we like the cover crops, especially the annual ryegrass, because we want something growing out there as long as possible. And it may go dormant a little bit in the winter time, but it turns around and wakes up back in the spring. So with that alone, we want to keep feeding that living soil.